let's start with the question, what do you believe in? Or rather ask yourself, who do you believe in? The thing is, I've always known God, but I never really had a relationship with Him. I was raised as a Catholic, going to church every Sunday, going to midnight masses during Christmas, taking part in not eating meat during the Lenten season. It was a tradition, a lifestyle, but I never knew the real intention of doing it. Why am I doing this? I asked myself. I'm pretty sure everyone at some point in their life doubted themselves and their fate. To doubt your fate is such a crucial thing. You don't know who you are, your identity. You are lost and living life without a purpose. So I am here to tell you my story, and I hope this will give you a chance to see things in a different perspective, to see things through the eyes of God. For letting God in your life is a privilege, and it will be one of the best choices you'll ever make, because it sure was the best decision I ever made. In one chapter of my life, I was going through a tough time. I was only 14 years old when I learned the true meaning of life. One of my loved ones passed away. I saw him disappearing in front of me. Life in him was slowly taking over by death. To experience such a thing is heartbreaking. And I know that your story is way different than mine, but listen. It was in this point in my life where I asked God, why are you doing this to me? What did I ever do to feel this pain and hopelessness? I realized then that God sent me an angel to guide me. I just never took the time to appreciate and acknowledge His presence. He's always been by your side, the happiest moment, the saddest part, the struggles and the pain you are feeling, He is with you, watching and protecting you. One night, I had a vision. I was running away from my problems, fear, doubts, and all the negative things in life. From afar, I see light, hope, strength, and courage, and all the good things, for it was God waiting for me. I ran as fast as I can, and He was there kneeling, and He called my name, my child, come to me, inviting me to His open arms. Tears ran down my cheeks as I reached Him and fell over His shoulders. The embrace of a father is something a daughter will never forget. There are no words to describe what it felt. I was protected, I was secured. I remember waking up from that dream, feeling the overwhelming presence of God. I was young back then, but I knew God called me for my purpose, to share His greatness and His grace to everyone in this world. So I decided to give everything that makes me happy to God. In His hands is my life, everything. I laid it all in front of Him. I was left with nothing but His everlasting love. I felt free, my soul and spirit reunited as one. My thoughts were cleared and my relationship with God was closer than ever before. There were times when I felt lonely and isolated, but that was just part of it. It might be hard right now, but you will get through it. For God's plan for us is greater than our thoughts. You might not understand why this is all happening, but someday you will. So when people ask, why am I living life like this? I do things differently, and that is because it is God who lives in me. He is all that I need, He is enough. I have all essential things in life, food to eat, family and friends who loves and supports me, and most importantly, God who will provide me. If God will provide, then what else could I ask for? There are no greater things than God. I am telling you, to be in His presence is the most wonderful feeling, and I could not emphasize that enough. Whatever you are struggling with, seek Him and you will find peace. God showed Himself to me in my lowest point in life, for the Bible says He is closest to the heartbroken. He will never give up on you no matter what. I failed so many times, I stumble and fall, but God is forgiving, and no matter what your past was, whatever you did, if you are willing to let go and let Him in your heart, God will save you. Save you from temptations and all the sinful things in this world. You will find strength and He will fill you up with His love. For His love for us is so great that He sacrificed Himself even when He knew that we might not love Him back. And this, I tell you, is true love. Whoever is watching this, take a moment to just think about where you are in your fate. Are you searching, lost or stuck? Or have you been found and saved? Wherever you are in your journey, I am praying for you. Lord God, help them to find what their heart is searching for. Fill them with your goodness and your never-ending love. Give them the courage and wisdom so they could find a path where it will lead them to their purpose. For you are the way, the truth, and life. Amen.